Learn how to make realistic natural stone countertops with Stone Coat Epoxy, saving you tons of time and money on your DIY kitchen or bathroom project. And when the two colors mix while that alcohol is wet, that's when the magic happens. You can do a whole kitchen with this style for under $250, which is thousands cheaper than any other countertop solution you can find. I'm trying to match blue pearl granite. I'm not sure if I could pull this one off. Remodel in a weekend with Stone Coat Epoxy. This process is really simple. Stay tuned and enjoy the video. You got this. Hey guys, I'm Mitch Quist. I'm excited to teach you how to save a ton of money today. I grew up in the construction industry with my dad. It was tough. I installed granite countertops for over a decade, and one of my favorite colors was blue pearl. Today, you're going to learn how easy it is to replicate blue pearl or any other natural stone using two metallic powders, some isopropyl alcohol, and clear Stone Coat Epoxy. Making that metallic spray that gives this project all that visual interest is really simple. Heck, it's magical. All you need to do is have 91% isopropyl alcohol, full bag, 16 ounces, or half a bag to 8 ounces. I really like this Zep sprayer. You can modify the spray mist. It could be really heavy or really fine. And this product is ready to mist on the countertop. It's always best practice to test out your epoxy techniques and projects on a smaller scale. The metallic powders are natural, real, metallic, and minerals that will settle to the bottom of that alcohol. Give it a good shake every time before you spray. A little too fine of a mist, I'm gonna go heavier. Okay, I could go with that for now. So holding your bottle a good foot or two away from your project, pump that trigger. The key to this type of project is layering the metallic sprays, letting it dry, coming back, hitting it with more color. What's up, folks? We need your opinion. Does this granite effect look natural or not? I use spray paint and our magic metallic mixture to make this granite effect. Does it help or hurt my piece? Let me know in the comments below. Now back to the video. I'm really pleased with how this looks. It's gonna look awesome with epoxy on top. I'm gonna grab my board. It's time to go do this on a larger scale. All right, I learned a ton doing my tiny little sample board here. One, I really love these two colors together. Changing the size of the metallic spray droplets coming out can give the project a really cool effect. Today we are going over a piece of wood. I've painted the project with two coats of our black undercoat. I rounded the top and bottom. That encourages the epoxy to flow over those edges evenly. Before misting on the metallic spray, I'm gonna lightly sand with 220 grit sandpaper. Hit those edges. All right, it's time to mist on my metallic powder. I'm gonna start with royal blue and I'm gonna hit my edges first. Both colors, I'm gonna hit those edges. I'm gonna let that dry before going to the surface or field of your countertop. Make sure the spray bottle is working properly before hitting those edges. All right, I like those droplets. I'm gonna hold this back about a foot to 20 inches and then hit those edges. Nice, that's looking good. It's okay if you get a little bit on the surface of your project. Don't worry, I'm gonna come back and heavily mist, but right now I'm trying to focus on the edges. Okay, my edges are nice and dry. I'm now gonna hit the surface of my project. I'm gonna do a couple layers, letting the alcohol dissipate and evaporate in between layers and fully dry. And make it rain. I'm doing about quarter pools. I really like the different size droplets that are coming out. And when the two colors mix while that alcohol is wet, that's when the magic happens. That silver and blue together looks fantastic. I'm gonna come back with a little more blue and then I'm gonna let this dry. All right, round two. Give it a good shake every time. That metallic likes to settle. Still looking nice. Yeah, bring that in. I really like how the different size drops are coming out. That's perfect. So looking at the project as a whole, I love how uniform it is. Check that out. That's looking cool.
Yeah. What colors did you use?
I used a royal blue and silver.
Royal blue. Oh, royal blue is one of those new colors.
It is. It's looking sick in there.
I love this. Have you guys seen the new colors yet? I haven't seen this color yet. This one is tight. Royal blue, man.
You can customize this style of epoxy technique to fit your space by simply changing the metallic powder color. Over on our website, we have the Epoxy Color Center with over 52 different color options.
You're bound to find two colors that will fit your style to renew your countertops. The epoxy color possibilities are endless.
Layer two is dry and it looks fantastic. Looks a lot like natural stone. I am pleased with it. I'm ready to mix up my clear stone coat countertop epoxy. This project calls for very little epoxy. I'm gonna mix up 3 ounces per square foot, and I'm gonna use our stone coat countertop epoxy. Stone coat epoxy is a 1-to-1 ratio epoxy by volume, and you mix for 2 minutes with a paddle mixer. I'm gonna first pour in 16 ounces of part B, followed by 16 ounces of part A. I'm gonna mix for 2 minutes holding the bucket. Midway through mixing, slow that paddle mixer down, rub the sides and bottom to incorporate any undermixed epoxy, and then pick it back up to full speed for another minute. A couple keys to success when I go to apply this epoxy. The color techniques are on the top of my board, so when I go to trowel, trowel with light pressure. Just let that glide right across the surface so you don't scratch any of that metallic you missed it on. Pour your epoxy down the center of your project. Using the notch trowel, lightly trowel the epoxy over itself. This mixes the epoxy another time here on the surface of the project. And then with very light pressure, spread your material out, keeping it away from your edges at first. This is pretty fun. It's not hard. Just letting that trowel glide right across my surface, evenly spreading the epoxy. Use your gloved hand to rub out any dry areas and help the epoxy flow. I am now gonna chop the top with a paintbrush. I'm first gonna wet it out with the residual epoxy left in my mixing bucket, and then in a random pattern, use the heel of that brush, chop the entire surface.
This step eliminates the trowel lines and mixes the material one more time.
All those trowel lines are gone, the surface is chopped. Now take your brush and with light pressure, rub those edges. I'm barely using any pressure when I do that. I'm now gonna use heat to remove the air incorporated into that epoxy. You could use a heat gun, you could use a blow dryer or a propane torch. You're gonna sweep the surface of the epoxy holding the torch head an inch or two off the surface.
Stone coat epoxy is DIY friendly. You have a long time to work with it. It doesn't stink. You can work with this right in your own home.
I'm quite pleased with how this project looks just the way it is. It's ready to go, but I'm gonna level it up another step. I'm gonna fog and fracture this project using some gloss black Rust-Oleum spray paint and a little bit of that same mixture, 91% isopropyl alcohol and silver metallic powder. I'm gonna fog and quickly follow with some spritz of this mixture. Just make sure that's working right, which it is, and you're gonna fog, quickly mist. Fog and mist. Ooh, cool. So hold the can about 12 inches, 15 inches off the surface, apply a little bit of that paint, and then quickly follow by the metallic mixture. That's looking sweet. As you can see, I'm kind of hitting smaller sections at a time. I'm not hitting my whole project.
Jump on over to our website, Stone Coat Epoxy, and see all the products used in this video. This epoxy really works, and you can do it over your countertops.
The key for success for the fog and fracture is to quickly follow your fog with that metallic mixture.
You can continue to layer this effect until your desired look is achieved. It really is as simple as it looks.
You can do a whole kitchen with this style for under $250, which is thousands cheaper than any other countertop solution you can find.
This project turned out fantastic, and I really love how the fracturing brought out the metallic powders down below. When the light hits that metallic powder, it looks amazing and realistic.
This project was do-it-yourself friendly and super simple. In our next video, Mike sprays these two cans on a project. It looks just like granite. He covers it with Stone Coat Epoxy. It only took him minutes, and that project is epic. Remember, from Stone Coat Countertops, you've got this, and we'll see you on the next video.
Stone Coat Countertops, you got this.